Welcome to this series of videos on accessibility requirements for public procurement of ICT products and services in Europe, the EN301549 standard. This is video 11. It's sponsored by Microsoft and produced by Funka. My name is Susanna Lorin. I'm an accessibility expert with a long experience in standardization. In this video, we are going to look at Chapter 11 of the EN301549 standard. This chapter covers software. Chapter 11 is in parts based on Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, or WCAG 2.0, which are referred to in Chapter 9 of the standard. In video 9.1 and 9.2, we have described WCAG more in detail. If you haven't seen those videos, you should do so before watching this one. But if you already know what the success criteria in WCAG cover, you can continue with this video. So, what does software mean? In this context, software means platform software, software that provides a user interface including content that is in the software, authoring tools, and software that operates as assistive technology. The first subsection in this chapter is an informative, general section that defines the scope of the chapter. It does not contain any requirements in itself. The second subsection includes references on how WCAG 2.0 should be applied to software. The third subsection covers interoperability with assistive technology. 11.4 is documented accessibility usage, and in subsection 5 we find user preferences. The last subsection of Chapter 11 covers specific requirements on authoring tools. 11.2, Non-Web Software Success Criteria. This is a large subsection. There are references to all success criteria in WCAG. Some of them do not apply to non-web software and therefore do not contain any requirements. But most of the success criteria in WCAG are relevant to non-web software. For each of those success criterion, there is a short text with comments on the differences in how to use the criterion when it comes to non-web software in comparison to web pages. We are not going to talk about each individual success criterion here. In the EN standard, there are comments on a few of the success criteria regarding how they should be interpreted when it comes to non-web software. You should read these comments. In this video, we are going to focus on why there is a difference in more general terms. Web Content Accessibility Guidelines were developed for web content, with the aim to be technology independent. This makes the guidelines more robust over time, since new technology can be covered by the same guidelines. And it means that they can be used for technology that is not web content. Since WCAG only specifies how the interface should work, not how the requirements should be met, we can use it for non-web things, like non-web software. Let's have a look at an example. In WCAG, there is one success criterion called 1.4.1, Use of Color. This criterion states that color is not used as the only visual means of conveying information, indicating an action, prompting a response, or distinguishing a visual element. This is, of course, important when you have a web page, but it is equally important in non-web software, or in documents, or even printed information. This is an example of a success criterion in WCAG that is just as relevant for non-web software as it is for web content. How we meet the requirement can vary depending on situation, solution, and technology. In video 5, we talked about the concept of closed functionality. When it comes to non-web software, there is an important difference if your software has open or closed functionality. Closed functionality means software where it is not possible to use assistive technology, for example, software in ticket machines. If the software does not have closed functionality, you should use subsection 11.2.1. If it has closed functionality, you should use 11.2.2 instead. The main difference is that software with open functionality is more related to web content than software with closed functionality. Therefore, software with open functionality in section 11.2.1 refers to Chapter 9 of the EN standard, which is based on WCAG. And closed functionality in 11.2.2 mainly refers to Chapter 5 of the EN standard. When you have open functionality, you need to implement the interface in a way that makes it possible for assistive technology to interpret it and present the information to the user. When you have closed functionality, you need to provide the functionality of the assistive technology as well, which means that you have much bigger freedom in how you make sure that users get the relevant information. 11.2.1 Non-web software success criteria, excluding closed functionality. When you have software without closed functionality, the requirements are pretty much the same as for web content and non-web documents. There are a handful of success criteria that is not relevant for non-web software, but most of the requirements are relevant. How you meet them will differ, but you should meet them. It's worth mentioning that you can sometimes achieve better accessibility by using accessibility services provided by platform software. There are examples of interfaces where assistive technology, the operating system, and software can meet and exchange information. A strategy that often works quite well is to use standardized components in the platform rather than inventing them from scratch. Usually, someone has already thought of accessibility. If you want to do something completely new, you can. But you need to make sure that it can be handled by assistive technology, and that requires quite a lot of testing and development. 11.2.2 Non-web software requirements, closed functionality. To make the numbering of requirements in the EN301549 consistent with WCAG 2.0, the EN standard contains empty parts where there is a success criterion for something in Chapter 9 that is not relevant to non-web software. For example, requirements on headings and labels, link purpose and focus order are very specific requirements for web interfaces. In total, there are 26 empty parts here. This might seem strange, but in reality, there are more requirements for this type of software, since the user needs must be catered for in other ways than those referred to in WCAG. In subsection 5.1 in the EN standard, there is a set of requirements dedicated for ICT with closed functionality. In many cases, part of the solution for closed functionality software might be met with hardware rather than software. There are 13 requirements in this subsection, and they refer to requirements that you can find in Chapter 5. Please have a look at Video 5 in this series for more details. There are two requirements that are worth mentioning, since it can be a bit difficult to see how they correlate. These two requirements can be looked at together, because they are interconnected. 11.2.2.7 Info and Relationships, which is based on WCAG 2.0, Success Criterion 1.3.1 Info and Relationships, and 11.2.2.8 Meaningful Sequence, which is based on WCAG 2.0, Success Criterion 1.3.2 Meaningful Sequence. When the ICT is closed to assistive technology for screen readers, and there is visual information on the screen, the ICT should provide information via audio that allows the user to understand the relationship between the audio and the information displayed on the screen. Examples of auditory information that allows the user to correlate the audio with the information displayed on the screen include information structure, navigation, and the like. The goal of these requirements is to make sure that users get all relevant information in a meaningful order, but also that it should be a correlation between the visual and auditory information. The visual object that is described with sound should be highlighted visually, and users should receive information on visual relationships. For example, select yes or no by pressing one of the two buttons below. 11.3 Interoperability with assistive technology. This subsection covers requirements to ensure that software works well together with assistive technology. Note that ICT with closed functionality of software that conforms with subsection 5.1, closed functionality, does not have to conform with the requirements in 11.3. For other software, subsection 11.3 includes 17 requirements. We are not going to go into detail of these 17 requirements, But if you have software, you need to go through this subsection and identify the requirements that are relevant for your situation. You will, for example, find requirements for platform software, like operating systems, and requirements on assistive technology. The EN standard offers the common requirements for operating systems, but all mainstream operating systems have more specific accessibility API requirements. We recommend that you consult how to use these APIs right from the operating system developers. 11.4, Documented Accessibility Usage, is a small subsection that only consists of two requirements. 11.4.1, User Control of Accessibility Features. When the software is a platform, like a mobile operating system, for example, you have to make sure that there is a way for the user to control the accessibility features of your platform. 11.4.2, No Disruption of Accessibility Features. When the software has a user interface, it should not disrupt the accessibility features, except when the user asks for it. 11.5, User Preferences. When the software has a user interface, the user must be able to make individual settings for color, contrast, font type, font size, and focus cursor. When the software is isolated from its underlying platform, it has no access to the user settings in the platform. In that case, this requirement cannot be met. The last subsection, 11.6, Authoring Tools, is targeted on software that contains functions to create, edit, and maintain content. So a content management system is one type of authoring tool. A text editor is another example. This subsection consists of five requirements. 11.6.1, Content Technology. Authoring tools must meet the requirements of subsections 11.6.2 to 11.6.5 when it comes to output. These are minimum requirements. Try to make it easy for the user to create accessible content. 11.6.2, Accessible Content Creation. Authoring tools must make it possible to produce content that conforms to Chapter 9, Web Content, or 10, Non-Web Content. Authoring tools can sometimes use additional tools for specific tasks. For example, a video editing tool may enable the creation of video files for distribution via broadcast television and the web, but authoring of caption files for multiple formats may be provided by a different tool. 11.6.3, Preservation of Accessibility Information in Transformations. If the authoring tool makes it possible to restructure or transform the content, for example by making tables into linear information or splitting documents to pages, accessibility information should be preserved. 11.6.4, Repair Assistance. When the authoring tool has a function for checking accessibility, and this function can detect that the content does not meet a requirement of Chapter 9 on web content or 10 on documents, the tool should offer a solution. For some kinds of purely technical accessibility problems, the tool can make automatic or semi-automatic repairs. 11.6.5, Templates. When the authoring tool provides templates that supports creation of content, at least one of them must conform to the requirements of Chapter 9 on web content or 10 on documents. The template should be marked as accessible. Remember, software is important. Chapter 11 is large and quite complex. This is because there can be very different conditions for software, and the standard tries to make sure that whatever the conditions are, developers should do their best to help users with or without disabilities. If you would like to know more, please have a look at our other videos. There is one video for each chapter in the standard. Thanks for watching.